In 1895, British science fiction author H.G. Wells published his novel, The Time Machine, about a dystopian, post-apocalyptic human society. In Wells's narrative, he explains that, following a period of devastating warfare, human evolution split into two groups. One, the Eloi, dwelling above ground, but being naive, and the other, the Morlocks, dwelling below ground and feeding on the Eloi. Wells had a long-time alliance with the democratic socialist, politically reformist Fabian Society, a brain trust and think tank to promote the ideals of democratic socialism in ways other than by armed revolution. In his 1928 book, The Open Conspiracy, Wells argued that groups of campaigners should advocate a world commonwealth governed by a scientific elite that would work to eliminate problems such as poverty and warfare. Wells reiterated his belief in the inevitability of a global government in his 1940 book, The New World Order, outlining his plans for how such a legislature should be established. In 1927, German expressionist film director Fritz Lang released his silent, feature-length motion picture adaptation of Thea von Harbou, his wife's, 1925 science fiction novel Metropolis. Produced and released during the Weimar era, between World War I and World War II in Germany, the film's being an inspiration to the burgeoning Nazi Party there, even while its director's 1932 anti-Nazi work, The Testament of Dr. Mabuse, was banned as an incitement to public disorder by Joseph Goebbels, led to Lang's divorce from Harbou in 1933. Lang emigrated to Paris in 1934, while Harbou remained in Germany and, in 1940, joined the Nazi Party officially. In the 1925 novel and 1927 film, Metropolis, on which Lang and Harbou had collaborated, wealthy industrialists reigned from high-rise tower complexes, while underground-dwelling workers toiled to operate giant machinery below. Again, the influence of Fabian socialism is hinted at by the premise that it is only the prodigal son of a wealthy top-world capitalist industrialist with a proletarian, working-class woman that can save the society from collapse when threatened by a sentient robot, prescient of the concept of artificial intelligence. In 1967, American film director George Lucas, who would, 10 years later, create the Star Wars franchise, produced the short film Electronic Labyrinth THX11384EB as a 23-year-old student at the film school of the University of Southern California. The USC program guide accompanying the film's screen debut described it as a nightmare impression in which a man is trying to escape a computerized world which constantly tracks his movements. Although it is never explicitly stated as the cause for the protagonist's desire to escape his largely automated society, the idea that he has illegally conceived a naturally born child in a society founded on eugenics, selective breeding, and cloning is further explored in the 1971 plotline of the, by then extended to feature-length, film called simply THX-1138. In 1983, Canadian film director David Cronenberg released his science fiction, body horror, feature-length motion picture Videodrome. Set in Toronto during the early 1980s, it follows the CEO of a small UHF television station who stumbles upon a broadcast signal featuring extreme violence and torture. The layers of deception and mind control conspiracy unfold as he uncovers the signal's source and loses touch with reality in a series of increasingly bizarre and violent organic hallucinations. Videodrome has been described as techno-surrealist. On May 5th, 1989, the 16th episode of the second season aired of the CBS television series Star Trek: The Next Generation, a reboot begun in 1987 of the original series begun in 1966 by Gene Roddenberry. This show, called Q Who, introduced the audience to what would later become a long-standing antagonist pseudo-species in the Star Trek science fiction franchise, set in the 24th century CE of our own Milky Way galaxy, called the Borg. In Star Trek, the Borg are a collection of species that have been turned into cybernetic organisms, functioning as drones in a hive mind called the Collective, or the Hive. The Borg use a process called assimilation to force other species into the Collective by injecting microscopic machines called nanoprobes, as well as by surgically adding cybernetic parts. They also usually have one arm, replaced with a prosthetic one, bearing one of a variety of multipurpose tools in place of a humanoid hand. The cube-shaped spaceships used first by the Borg in the series were considered aesthetically innovative, and the episode in which they debuted, Q Who, was nominated for the Outstanding Special Visual Effects Emmy Award by the Academy of Television Arts and Sciences. The Borg motto is, "Your biological and technological distinctiveness will be added to our own. Resistance is futile." Before the 1996 movie, Star Trek: First Contact, the Borg were depicted as exhibiting no hierarchical command structure, instead using a structure similar in principle to the Internet, with no control center and distributed processing. In First Contact, the character of a Borg queen is introduced, whom travels through time in a spherical spaceship, and whose sporadic deaths and rebirths result in schisms throughout the Borg collective. In 1997, Canadian film director Vincenzo Natali co-wrote and directed a dystopian science fiction film called Cube, which was followed by a sequel film, Cube Squared, Hypercube, written by Sean Hood, directed by Andre Sekulia, and produced by Ernie Barbarash in 2002, and a prequel film, Cube Zero, written and directed by Ernie Barbarash in 2004. All three films are centered, with slight variations, on the same science fictional setting, a gigantic mechanized cubicle structure of unknown purpose and origin, made up of numerous smaller cubicle rooms in which most or all of the principal characters inexplicably awaken in the opening scenes. Each of these rooms has six heavy vault doors, one on each face of a cube, which lead into adjacent, largely identical rooms, differing occasionally by color of lighting. Some of these rooms are safe, while others are equipped with deadly booby traps, such as flamethrowers or razor wire. In some cases, it is possible to detect a trap by throwing an object into the room first, although this method is not always reliable due to the trigger mechanism of certain traps. Cube gained notoriety for its surreal atmosphere and Kafkaesque setting, with its industrial room design and concept of entrapment. The film's writer, Vincenzo Natali, supposedly wrote a script detailing the world outside the cube, but destroyed it after deciding not to create a movie about it. On March 31, 1999, American filmmakers the Wachowskis, the then brothers named Larry and Andy, since renamed the sisters Lana and Lily, respectively, following Lana's transgender surgery in 2008 and Lily's 2016 revelation of having been transgender for her whole life, released their action movie summer blockbuster, The Matrix, about a dystopian future in which reality as perceived by most humans is actually a simulated reality called The Matrix, created by sentient machines to subdue the human population, while their body's heat and electrical activity are used as an energy source. Inventing innovative cinematography, so-called bullet time, and fight scene choreography, so-called wire foo, the film encourages the viewer to suspend their disbelief in their own reality outside of the theater itself, and leaves the audience wondering if their own world is also only a virtual reality simulation. The protagonist, a computer programmer self-titled Neo, learns this truth and is drawn into a rebellion against the machines of the future, which also involves other people who have been freed from the dream world and who live in an underground city called Zion. On April 13, 2012, already then renowned American fantasy genre television series creator and 1996 founder of Mutant Enemy Production Company, and since 2012, Marvel comic book film and television series writer and director Joss Whedon co-wrote with longtime collaborator, American screenwriter Drew Goddard, on Goddard's directorial debut, releasing a film called The Cabin in the Woods. The plot follows a group of college students who retreat to a remote forest cabin where they fall victim to backwoods zombies and the two technicians who manipulate the ongoing events from an underground facility. The film has been classified as the genre horror comedy, described by its creators as an attempt to revitalize the slasher film genre, and as a critical satire on torture porn. As the plotline progresses in the film, it is revealed the technicians in the military base below the surface were manipulating events above ground as a means of offering the college students up as human sacrifices to even deeper underground elder gods who come to rise up at the very end of the film. The movie, The Cabin in the Woods, makes use of previous themes from other movies, such as the Cube Trilogy, The Matrix, THX-1138, and Metropolis, in the form of an underground base, with a Rubik's puzzle prison level that keeps the surface dwellers under constant surveillance. Alike also in H.G. Wells' Time Machine, the underground Morlocks did to the surface-dwelling Eloy, but explains the appropriation of these tropes as being in service to still deeper and more ancient sleeping gods. The more recent and perhaps more obvious reference by this may be to H.P. Lovecraft, American author, 1890 to 1937, who wrote of such chthonic deities as monsters in his novels. However, in real history, this underworld pantheon harkens back to the Eleusinian mysteries, originating from 1600 to 1100 BCE in Mycenaean Eleusis, Greece, in which the initiated traces the steps of the goddess Demeter, called in Chaldean Astarte, in Babylonian Ishtar and known in earliest Sumer as Inanna, and her daughter Persephone, called Ereshkigal, the sister of Inanna in the original Sumerian legends, the goddess of the harvest, and the queen of the underworld, wife of Hades, respectively. As they journey through a cave, examining effigies of past heroes, as well as of the wrathful, angry, vengeful, and jealous titans who preceded the contemporary Olympian gods. This cult became part of the inspiration for Plato's allegory of the cave. Practicing for liberation at death through a cave-based rebirth ritual has evolved until modernity into the initiation rituals of the Blue Lodge of free and accepted masonry. Also note the design of most theaters in Western civilization, following Shakespeare's Globe, has been increasingly enclosed and emphasizing the proscenium arch, or fourth wall, dividing audience from actors. The surface itself became a screen in 20th century film theaters.